In this illustration, we intend to simulate the spring back process in the Abaqus software. As you know, after the completion of the deep drawing process, due to the spring back phenomenon, the sheet deviates from its desired shape and loses its desired shape, and a slight deviation occurs in the sheet. And it can be clearly observed in this picture. In this question, we use one static step in order to simulate the spring back process. And during this step, the sheet is separated from the other parts and stands freely in the ambit. In this picture, the stress contours have been compared together during the time before and after the spring back process. As you observe, the quantity of stress have diminished after the spring back process. Actually, in the right picture, residual stress can be observed. I will enter the Abaqus software for simulation. First, I'll make a copy of this model and name that spring back and OK. Here I'll open the spring back model, then enter the part module. Here remove the die, punch and holder parts. Then enter assembly module and remove die, holder and punch parts in this module. Enter into the interaction module and here start removing all the interactions. Then I'll click on special menu, select inertia and manager and remove the concentrated mass which had already been defined for holder. After that, I'll enter the step module. Here remove dynamic explicit step, then click on create and select static general step. The analysis is done in non-linear form. I will enter maximum number of increments equal to 10,000. Enter initial increment size equal to 0.001 seconds and maximum equal to 0.1 seconds and OK. Then I will enter load module. Here I'll remove this boundary condition and this boundary condition 2. Then click on create. Here select displacement rotation and continue. Then I will select this node. Done and close U3 boundary condition for it. Then click on create predefined field. Here select initial state and continue. I will select the whole of sheet. Done. Here we should write down the name of previous job. Actually, we should type the job title of deep drawing process here. And here you can observe the name of the previous job, that is square deep drawing 1. In fact, This is the statement I should type here. Actually, all the outcomes for previous model, including deformation, stress, strain, displacement, will be considered as the inputs for the new existing model, or in other words, the output of deep drawing process will be considered as the input for spring back process. To put it in more simple words, having done this, the end of the deep drawing process will be regarded as the start of the spring back process. Here you are suggested to tick on the update reference configuration option. Actually, if we tick on this option, the quantities of displacement will be reset at the start of the spring back process, meaning that the quantities of displacement having been obtained from deep drawing process will become equal to zero at the beginning of spring back process in formality. We should only note that the figure itself will be equal to zero here. In this manner, you can calculate the impact of the spring back process during the time of deformation of sheet much easier. Here, I'll click on OK, enter the job module, click on Create, continue, OK, and click on Submit. The analysis was done successfully, so I will click on Result. Here, we intend to survey the impact of the spring back phenomenon on the sheet after the deep drawing process. As you know, the sheet gets out of its normal shape during the spring back process and loses its desired shape. In fact, the spring back process is an undesirable phenomenon which causes the sheet to be deformed and lose its normal ideal shape after the deep drawing process is completed. Here you can observe the extent the sheet will be deflected. Here, in order to display the deformations in a better way, I will use magnification option and magnify the deformations up to tenfold of their normal sizes in this manner. After that, I'll click on Allow Multiple Plot States and then on Plot Undeformed Shape. In this manner, you can observe both deformed and undeformed shapes of the sheet. Here, you observe that the deformation and deflection of the sheet having been caused as a result of the spring back process. As it can be observed, a minor deformation will be created in the sheet, causing that to lose all its initial state and form. Here, I'll select the contour of displacement, then U3, here you can calculate the vertical displacement of the sheet caused by the spring back process. As you observe, the blue areas move as much as 0.45 millimeters downwards and the red ones as much as 0.25 millimeters upwards. The red and blue areas stand for minimum and maximum quantities of displacement. Here you can observe the vector of displacement on which these areas were displaced downwards and then upwards. Here you can also calculate the quantity of displacement of the sheet caused by the spring back process. As it can be observed here, the maximum of displacement having occurred in the red areas is equal to 0.46 millimeters. In the next step, we intend to calculate the contour of stress before and after the spring back process. Here, I will select the stress contour. Here, you can observe the contour of stress at the start of the spring back process. And here, the contour of stress can be observed at the end of the spring back process. As clearly observed, the quantities of stress have diminished caused by spring back phenomenon. And here the quantities of residual stress in the sheet has been displayed, which can be observed.